Review lets you view, manipulate, and mark up 3D PDFs just as well as 2D PDFs. You can easily navigate around the 3D model, focus only on certain parts, and see all of the elements of the model in the 3D model tree. Start by opening a 3D PDF. The 3D model toolbar will appear at the top of the document and allows you to better interact with a 3D model. The first button resets you to the default view. You then have defined views for observing the model. There's also an option to play through all of the views as necessary. To add a new view, position the model how you want to view it. Then click on Manage Views. Here you can add or remove, as well as edit all the views. Click on the plus button to add a new view. You can then give the view a name and set additional options, including specific lighting and rendering modes for that view only. Click Save to save the view. The 3D toolbar lets you decide the mouse interaction for navigating around the model. You can then use these to determine how you'll move around your 3D PDF. Rotate, spin, pan, zoom, camera, and select. There is then an option to view the model as orthogonal. The next options let you choose the viewing mode, including colorations or different types of wireframes, and different lighting types you can toggle through to get the proper representation of your model. You can then change the background color of the model area if necessary, or view and edit cross-section views. There is also the Transform option, which allows you to select an object in the model and move or rotate it relative to the rest of the drawing. And finally, some options for viewing markups in the 3D model. All of these options appear in the toolbar featured in the 3D model tree. The 3D model tree can be found with the markups list, and at first glance, functions much in the same way. You may need to activate it by right-clicking on the icons at the left and selecting 3D model tree at the bottom. The objects are shown as part of the overall model hierarchy. You expand individual groups using the plus and minus buttons next to the object or group names, or expand and contract all at once using the buttons at the top of the tree. You can filter objects based on the column criteria, and even search for objects using the search field. All of the metadata in the columns is also editable, should you need to make changes to it. Like the markup list, there are more than 50 3D model attributes that are given their own columns in the 3D model tree. You can select what columns are visible by clicking on the columns drop-down and checking or unchecking the defaults, or see all of the options when you click on Manage Columns. At some point, you'll probably want to use all of that metadata you have associated with a 3D model, and that's where Summary comes in. Click on the Summary option to export the metadata to a CSV file that you can use to share the data.